Okay, everybody, welcome back to the channel. Today, we've got our Android phone and we've got our Xbox controller. I'm going to show you how to get them connected and we're going to play some Minecraft. All right, guys, first things first. If you've got a USB-C to USB-C cable, you can just plug your Xbox controller straight in to your phone and it's plug and play. It'll just load up and Minecraft will look a little bit like this. And you can just start playing through with your normal settings. Look at that. Going up and down, working perfectly. So that's a really easy way to do it. But let's look at how to get it connected over Bluetooth. All right, guys, when you turn on your Xbox controller, this little area here might just light up straight away. That means that it's already connected to something on the Bluetooth, probably your Xbox console, or maybe, like me, it's your PC. You need to make sure that you go onto your PC or go to your Xbox and turn off that particular controller, and it will do this. It'll turn off, then turn it on again, and it'll start flashing. Okay, if it's flashing slowly like that, it means that it isn't connected to anything. Then what we're going to do is we're going to press and hold the scan button on the back. We're going to hold that until it starts flashing quickly, and then we're going to go to our phone, go to the Bluetooth settings, make sure that's turned on, and we're going to scan. And when the light turns solid like that, it means you are connected up to your phone. So let's see what it's like playing some Minecraft with our Xbox controller. All right, so here we are in Minecraft Education Edition, and we're just gonna quickly create a new world using the controller. Yeah, it's so much easier. Right trigger to break blocks. Left trigger to place them. Go to my inventory. If you use the D-pad, it kind of snaps clicks to roughly where you want it to go, which is quite cool. I can press the up button to change my view, which on mobile takes ages. Changing between third person, first person can take a really long time. And all in all, a way better experience. If you are a mobile user and you happen to have an Xbox controller laying around, then this could be a really useful thing to have. It's awesome, actually. I like it a lot. Way better than using the touchscreen. Right, guys, we're going to finish up the video there. Thanks for watching to the end. If you could please leave a like and even subscribe, that would be amazing. And I'll see you all later in the week.